Hey guys, welcome to another video by the Trainsome Guy. This video is going to be a sort of lengthy video. It's going to be a tutorial on how to build what you see here. This is basically an example of a Great Western style station. I love Great Western sort of stations and infrastructure. So I use them a lot on my routes, and so yeah, I just thought I would do a little tutorial video on how to make a very detailed and very atmospheric station using just a couple of assets really, or from different assets. Obviously, as you can see, there's probably a lot in here, and it will take a bit of time, but you know, what I believe in the philosophy of very large amount of detail very close to the track, and a very small amount of detail very far away from the track, because you're going to be here at the track, you're going to be driving the train, and so when you arrive at the station, you want it to look really good, really nice, really detailed, but you don't really want to care about the trees that are a couple hundred meters away. So let's get started. Okay, so first things first, what we're going to do is we're going to load up some assets into this route. We're going to be creating a Western style route, so we're going to need some Western style assets. And the first place to go, really for me, is Exeter to Kingswear. This came out in the Train Simulator 2016 game, and also is now released onto the Steam store page. Fantastic bit of DLC, pick it up if you haven't got it. It's absolutely stunning. The other piece of scenery we're going to need is Falmouth. Now Falmouth is one of my all time favourite DLC packs, so I use it on pretty much every single route I've ever made. It's really good, really versatile, and it's got some really nice looking assets. So, now that we've got Falmouth and Exeter Kingswear, we're going to start building. Now the first place we're going to start is the track, so we're going to make a little two track station, and I'm simply going to have two lines of track, about yay big, yeah. Make it yay big. Move it over here a little bit. Okay. So this is going to be our starting point. What we're going to use. So this is just a straight bit of track. What I'm going to do straight away is I'm going to get rid of this little gap here by moving the track pieces closer together. Obviously what this will do is it means that when you then come to extend the track that the pieces won't align properly. We'll get this gap here. So all you need to do to fix that is to go to over here to this, which is the join tool, and click on the join tool, click on the piece of track you want to move, and then click the other piece of track you want to move it to, like so. Now it does create a join here, and these basically they're render points, so sort of a break in the render system, so if you have something that goes over it, it won't render properly on the game. For example, I will show you what happens when I do this. So as you can see, because this piece of track here is intersecting with this junction, it's not rendering the junction on this side, because it is rendering the track, so it might need to bear that in mind, especially if you've got quite a complicated junction. But we're just going to stick with this line here. Okay, so once I've laid the track, what we're going to do is do the station. Now the simplest way, there are two ways of doing this. You can either draw the platform itself, or you can, which is like this, so go over here and you draw platform 1 like this, and then you raise it up Now the problem with this is you've got to then very skillfully rotate it so that it's certain sort of level with the track, so it's parallels with the track. And this can be very, very difficult, especially if you have corners. If you have a corner platform, not that steep, not that sharp even. If you have a corner platform that looks like that, for example, and then you've got to match up a piece of track to it, that's going to be very hard. So there is an inbuilt tool into the game. If you go over here to the select tool, we're going to select a piece of track like this. So just simply click the select tool, click on the piece of track, and you get this little slide box which you then slide over how long you want to select, and then you click the offset button. And what this basically does is that it creates a path that follows the piece of track that you selected, and if your track winds around, it'll follow it exactly, and you can choose over here how far from the track you want it to follow. So this is 5, which I assume is 5 meters. I could be wrong. Now what I'm going to use the Exeter Kings with disused platform. Now there's something to bear note with platforms in Train Simulator, is that they don't, sometimes these little arrows confuse you. So the arrow is the direction which the asset points towards the track. So if I do this one here, you'll notice that the platform edge is the opposite side of the track. If I do this one over here, see the arrow is pointing this way. If I then turn it that way, it will then do the same. So I'm not entirely sure why it does this. I believe there might be some coding in there somewhere. But anyway, so we're selecting this piece of track. We're now going to switch the arrow and then put down our disused platform. Now, what this does is that it puts in a platform at the same height as the track. So if we go into our gradient tool, we can see the track here is 0.36 above ground level. And that basically means because there's ballast underneath the track, so obviously the track is a little bit higher. Otherwise it would be, if it was down at zero, it would look like this, which is obviously no good at all. So, and now obviously platforms aren't this low, so we have to raise the platform up. So you simply click up the gradient, click on the piece of platform and raise it up and down. What I found generally is 1.4, if you look over here, if I hover over the gradient tool, you can see there's a height which changed from 0.36 to 1.44. That's roughly where what I believe to be a good height for platforms. So you raise up the platform, and then we need to move it towards the track. Now, a very quick little tip that I learned. You quickly go to the scenario editor and just stick in a coach like this, and then go back into your terrain editor, and this then allows you to put the platform near to the track and make it look like it's sort of a correct distance apart. Otherwise it's, you know, it can be too close like this, and then you have a problem. So you can use this tool, you can use this movement tool to sort of get the platform just about right. And this also allows you sort of a guide to sort of check how high the platform is compared to the coach. So this seems to be alright to me, so we're going to leave this here. What we can also do, we'll do the other side now as well. Going to put this along. I might actually make this side a little bit shorter. We'll do that up to there. Turn out the arrow, go back into this used platform, raise this one up. Oops, there's it. There we go, and then over to here, what are we going to do? This side as well. Okay, and then we're going to go and move this across. I'm going to do this one by eye, because you can roughly use this as a guide. You can roughly work out, okay, so, you know, how far into the ballast is it? Replicate it on this side. About there, that'll do. So, now we've got the beginnings of a station. We'll just get rid of this carriage. So, right back into the editor. Now, we've got platforms at either end. Now we need to sort of slope them off. Now what I'm actually going to do is I'm going to cut these platforms off just at the ends, just so that we can add a little sloping on. So, to do this, we're going to use the split tool. And what we want to do is sort of cut the end off this platform. Now we can do that by clicking on the platform, so click on the split tool and then click on the platform and it breaks it for you. If you are doing splitting multiple lofts at the same time, what's always good is that you can, if you click and hold, you can drag left and right and do this. And this allows you to cut not only the platform but any loft tools in between. Now this is not the end of the world. You can always delete these and then extend them on later. But what this allows you to do is to do this and delete the platform. Now there are two ways of adding platforms, end caps, which is a little angle, but you can, if you want, leave it here and then just simply drag this bit to the bottom like so. But since some platforms have a spawn area on top of them, if you continue the spawn area down the slope, you get people spawning halfway into the ground. So I like to add end caps, which you can find in buildings, and you can find in the Exeter Kingsway under stations. So what we're going to do is just going to add these end caps on. Like so, line them up. Bed them in. Like so. And then we're going to copy and paste and put this over the other side. That'll do. Okay. Just rotate it slightly. Cool. Alright, then we're going to do the other side. So we're going to have to get this one out. Nope, this one. And then do the exactly the same. Oopsie daisy. Line it up and then drag it down. And what this actually shows is that that is the default height that the game reckons the platform will be. So I've actually made it a little bit lower than normal. You don't have to do this, it's just under personal preference. Okay, I'm going to copy and paste this over here. Oh, something else to bear note as well is that if when you copy and paste the asset, it as default it places it on ground level. If you don't want that to happen, if you go down to this box here, if you're using the recent tool set, is you can snap to terrain, and if you untick this, if you leave it ticked, it snaps the new terrain piece to the terrain. But if you then untick it, copy and paste, it then doesn't snap it to the terrain, it leaves it at its original height, which as you can see is already lower than normal. So this allows you, so if you set up a platform piece and you want to copy it a few times, you can always maintain its height and stuff. You don't have to rearrange everything. Becoming very important later on as we come to work on it. Okay, So now we've got some platforms looking pretty good. What I might actually do actually while I'm here is just cut this down a little bit, just to make it cool. Okay, now we're gonna save our work. It's very important to save. Okay, so we've got our platforms, we've got some track. Now we're going to add some buildings. Just gonna add a few little buildings in here. So I'm gonna add a waiting room on this side of the track. We're gonna add one here. Here we'll do. Let's make it, you want it fairly close to the track, but you don't want it too close. You want there to be enough room so that people can walk around it, you know, and not feel like they're too close to the track. That'll do. On this side, we're going to add a good shed, which I can find on. Engine shed plus engine shed stone. Quickly just add this into the terrain and add this over here. Again, we want it fairly close to what we've got there. Okay, now obviously this is a asset, 2D asset, and so the platform goes inside. That's not the end of the world, we can fix that later on. Okay, any more buildings we want to add? Do we want to add any more buildings? Let's see now what to do. Do we want? There's a lot of stations. Let's go. Let's go down into station generic. Choose one of these. Let's go for this one. Now what I'm doing to rotate this is clicking and dragging, other than just placing down the asset like that. This is just a standard click. So let's add this here. This one up to there. And we'll add that there. Like so. Let's see, have a look. We might move this one here. We might move this one here because we want to add something in a minute. Oh, yeah, actually. One asset we didn't load is EP station or modeler's pack, which you can find in here. This is another asset which I use all the time because it's got some really, really good stuff in it. Mainly these blocks, which you can basically, I basically use like Lego bricks, and you can really build up some intricate and complicated stations with these. And they also help you in this situation. So what we need to do is we need to extend the station out so that we can have, so this station building here is actually not floating in the air. So to we're going to stretch this block out. So what we need to do is we need to go down here to the scale tool. Now if we click on the scale tool, you'll see this little yellow axis here. Now if this basically means it's locked into, all the axes are locked, so they work together. So when you expand it, the whole thing expands in unison, and its ratio is kept exactly the same. But if I unclick this sort of padlock here, what it does is it means you can control each axis independently. And so you, if you want something like this, and then you want to turn it into something long and thin, or maybe short and wide, you can. So we're going to want to put this about there. Yeah, a bit less, that'll do. And then we will raise it up like so. And then we'll do the same on the other side for the waiting room here. And about there. And then raise it up so that it is supported. Okay. Okay, now save our work again. I'm just gonna extend these track pieces. Right, now we need to add some fencing so we don't want people wandering off our platform. And we're gonna use the select tool again. But this time, instead of the track, you want to select the platform. So we're just going to select what we want here is a piece of fence that goes from here to about here. Now we can easily do this by selecting the platform roughly here and moving over to about here. Clicking the offset tool. Now here we can change how far away from the platform we want the fence. So if it's currently at 5, so we would set it down to 2.5. Sets it off to default, and we need to check where it will be compared to the edge of the platform. That looks about right, because this is a 5 meter wide platform, I assume, so 2.5 meters, you know, from the center. If you want to put something in the center of the platform, you can't actually put in 0. Maybe you can. No, it isn't like it. So you have to put 0.01. That puts it in as close as possible. So we'll leave it at 2.5, and we're going to add some extra fence 1. Okay, let's have a look. Now that is actually on the edge of the platform, just hanging off slightly, so we will move it in just a little bit. Okay. Then we're going to go over here, and we're going to do the same on this side. And we're going to change this to 2.3, just so we don't get anything hanging off the edge, like so. Is that too much? Ooh, might be too much. Move it slightly. Cool. You also might... is this floating? Oh, it is floating. Okay, so we will just drag this down a little bit. There we go. And do the same on the side. Like so. Alright, oh yeah, we're also going to have to do these bits. And what we could do at this point, we could keep going with the select tool. Actually, we're going to draw these now. But there is a problem we have, is that we're building up from ground level, and if you come and draw something on Train Simulator, it snaps it to ground level. So there's two options we can do. We can either draw it on ground level, like so, and then manually move it into position. Like thus. Actually not too bad. And then finish it off. This is one method. There we go, that works. Or we can do something else, which we'll actually need to use in a minute. And this is basically changing up the ground level by raising the terrain. Now normally when you raise terrain, you use one of these tools, which is you can manually raise it how you wish, or you can raise it slowly up and down. But there is actually a tool here, which is called the level tool. And this basically it's sort of like it allows you to raise the terrain or lower the terrain to a certain level. Now the level indicator down here corresponds to your level indicator on here. So if you go to this platform, it's 1.44 meters high. Go back to this tool and type in 1.44. And then raise up the terrain. It automatically raises the terrain to 1.44. Like so. And now we can see the terrain is at the dead level with the platform. So when we come to draw in our fences, they're automatically at level with the rest of the platform. So then we can simply drag and drop over here. Now you might not always be able to do this. But in this particular example, it's very beneficial. So we'll do that. Cool. And we'll just drop it in just slightly. Okay. Now one thing actually is that we can't actually see this bit here. So what we'll do is we'll lower the platform slightly, lower the ground level slightly, so we can see what we're doing. Now I'm just going to add some fences here in this way. Trim it off and then copy and paste it over here. Now, if you notice what happened there, because I had the snap to terrain tool disabled, it didn't snap to the increased height of this particular piece of terrain. So we have to do that here. After we re-enable the tool, it snaps it up to the correct height. When you use all these different tools, you've got to remember what setting they're on, otherwise you're going to start having stuff everywhere. And then we're also going to place it over here. Trim it off. And then copy it over here. Actually, no, we won't, because that's already snapped over. We're going to leave it here. Okay, so now we've got some fences on our platform, and it's starting to look pretty good. Now we're going to add some clutter. Now this makes all the difference. As you can see now, yeah, the station looks cool. You know, it's starting to look very atmospheric, but it's missing a few things. Actually, while I'm here, I'm just going to add some fence at the end of my platform. This is obviously to stop people from walking onto the track, and it's just a sort of realism check. Add one over here. I'm actually going to add this one further up. We'll make this one here, just to change it off slightly. Okay, so same once again. So yeah, as I was saying, we're not going to add a lot of detail to this route, and to do this we're going to use the clutter assets, and this is basically all the little things that aren't houses or shops or station assets. These are little tiny things like beach umbrellas and things like that, and also benches, wonderful benches. We've got a picnic bench, we've got benches with backs on, and what we want to do is fill up the station with all this clutter to make it look really, really good. So first of all, we're going to add some lights, because we like lights. Let's go for, where is it, Gaslight GWR, because this is a GWR themed station. So we're going to need a gaslight here for people to see when they're walking on and off the platform. Gaslight here, and then we're going to need a gaslight here, and I suppose we'll put one here. then we're gonna need. I suppose we could stagment them. Let's go for. We'll go for alternating like this. So I need one here. And then we need one here. And then we need one here. And then we need one here. And then we'll put one over here. Okay, so now they've got some nice lamps on the station. They are actually nicely spaced apart, which is good. Okay, now we're going to need some benches for people to sit on, even though they can't in this game, which is sad, really. You can get people already sat on benches, but you can't really get people to sit on benches. So we're going to add bench here. Get it up. And then now, because I've raised it up above the ground, gonna unclick the snap to terrain tool, and then we get so it means it will maintain its height. And we're gonna add a few benches. Gonna have one there. Gonna add one there. And we're gonna have one there. And then we'll have one down here. And we're gonna move it back over to here, and we do the same. Gonna have to this side. We're also gonna add a backless bench. One here. Actually, might do two here. Ooh. And then we'll put one over here under this bit. Okay. Now, what else are we going to do? We're going to add some billboards. So, advertisements are very important for rubber companies. So. A few little billboards here and there won't do anybody any harm. So let's add one of these. You don't want that many. There's a few period ones. Let's add one of these here. What else do we need? Oh yes, we need some names. Now Falmouth has a few really cool station boards, which are very, very Great Western in design. However, obviously, these stations exist in real life. So, if you have a station here that's called Truro, people will probably be thinking, "Oh, there's a Truro that already exists." But I suppose if you keep it at least regional, then it won't be so bad. We'll call it the station Truro. Add one of those there. I think we'll add one this side as well. We'll probably actually add it where this thing is here. And then move this along next to the light. Let's see if these can go higher. Nope, they can't. Undo that. Okay, now save it. Already, it's starting to look much better. But we need to keep going. There's more we can add. Let's see, what else can we add? Fire buckets. Yeah, we can add some fire buckets. Now, all this lot is really, it's not necessary, but a little bit of detail. Oh, a lot of detail goes a long way. You also have to bear in mind that this will obviously increase your asset count and your time in the game, so you need to be very wise with how many assets you add. And then flower pots. Love me flower pots. I have one there. We'll have one there. Have one in that corner. Have one in the between those two, and I have one over here. Flower troughs. Have one here. And we'll have one here. And we'll have one here. What else can we have? Lamps, litter bins. Need some rubbish bins. On the station. Put two to the side and we'll put one here. Like so. Luggage suitcase pile. A few suitcases for people. And then, what else? Milk churns. Ah, yes. A few milk churns. We'll put a couple down here. What else do we want? Ah, trolley GWR. Where should we put you? We'll put you here. We'll rotate you so that you're resting your little stick against the wall. Like so. Okay, so now, if we look at this in sort of a couple of minutes, we've transformed the station already. It's already looking quite grand, really. So now we need to drop the terrain back to its normal position so we can carry on with the track. Like so. Right, then we will add, let's add a water point, a water crane. Engines to get their water. Let's raise that up to there. Put it on there. Okay, so now the side, what we can do, we can perhaps leave some of this up. Oops, it easy. Create a grass area. Alright, let's add a few more bits. Let's add in a grass embankment. Embankment slope. Like this. Excuse me. And this will. Actually, no, we're going to use our select tool. Do this. I'm going to do this. Embankment slope. What this basically is doing is patching the hole between our terrain and our grass. Oh, hello. Big mistake. What's going on here? Oh dear. Cool, start that one again. Leave that one this way this time. There we go, that's much better. Okay. I'm going to do the same this side. To drag that around that way. Just drop it in. I'm going to sort out the terrain. Now in this situation, obviously that looks good, but we've got a little bit here, so what we can do, we can add in a tunnel hole decal. And what this does is that it basically makes any terrain it sees invisible. So if we edit that here and stick that over here like so, if we press going into the terrain, there we go, it removes it entirely. Now these are a bugger to select, unfortunately, but oopsie, no, that's not right. As you can see, they're a bugger to select. Let's do that here. We'll just relay this piece of track. Like so, let's try it again. It'll do for now. Okay. So, yeah. So let's have a look at this now. It's looking pretty good so far. We're just going to add a few bushes and hedges over here. So this is going to be our picnic area. I've decided it's going to be a picnic area. But first we want to get rid of this transition. Now to do that, we're going to hide it under a line of weeds. This is probably one of my favourite assets in the game. Because it's so versatile, you can use it for anything. What this line of weeds does is just helps take off the edge. It helps transition from one bit to the sort of this loft tile to the terrain. I'm just going to finish off this slope again here, this side, like we did to the other side. Probably going to raise this bit up as well. Whole decals. See what it looks like. Oh no, there's a whopping great big hole in our terrain. That's not good. So bad. What we can do, we can hide this. We shall hide it with a little bit of terrain. So let's go for sleeper mats. Yep. Stick this down there. Drop it in like so. It's not too bad, is it? It's just a little cosmetic change just to help us out. Okay, that's not too bad, it's not too bad. Okay, so let's keep adding a few more bits of scenery. I'm going to use some more weed lines. Let's use some down the middle of this track. So, and then we'll use some bushes. some brambles. And then we'll use some... No, we won't use one of those. We'll use these. Like so, and then we will maybe use a tree for one last touch. Just here, like so. Save it. And let's have a look at what one we have created. So, hopefully, if you guys have been following along, you'll have something that looks like this. And literally in about half an hour, 45 minutes, we've been able to create a station that looks really, really good. Lots and lots of detail. And when you arrive into it, you're driving your train, it just helps bring the atmosphere to life on your route. So, thank you very much for watching. If you're still here, please leave a like and a comment. In the comment box, subscribe to the channel. I love the feedback. I'm really trying to progress this channel and progress myself because this is sort of still new to me. So any helpful advice you can give me, I will receive very greatly. Take care, guys, and see you in the next video. Bye.